when you become an empty nester. Do we have any empty nesters here? Or people hoping the kids move out? We got a few. Here's the thing, you need to know, over here, I knew we had this thing. So here's the deal, guys, I gotta tell you. Millennials, I know you hate to hear this. Your parents are having sex and it's a blast, okay? And there's a little pinch someplace, you know? Just grosses the kids right out. It really does. But I have to tell you something that happened to us. We'll have the kids home, you know, for the holidays. And here's what happened to us last year. They wanted to surprise us, and they came home. They Ubered home together, which is unusual for them to agree to do anything together. But they did. And when they moved out, I started cleaning the whole house. Because your whole house becomes an opportunity for you to have intimate moment. You want the house clean for those possibilities.
Yeah.
Right? You do. I'm grossing some of you out right now. You're kind of getting, your little butts are going, oh God, this lady's over 35 and she's discussing sex. Oh my God. I feel like I'm back in 10th grade with the films. But anyways, the kids, they Uber home. We are in the kitchen. It's hot in the kitchen. If you follow me, and we hear the garage door go up, the garage door is going up, and we hear their little cherub voices, and then the key goes in the kitchen door, and we know they're coming in, and I grab the Bounty towel, and we wrap each other up, you know, and they walk in, and I just look at them and go, hurry up, here's some paper towel, we're going to a toga party, move! Good. Took me too long to get to the punchline, but you fucking went with me. Thank you. You guys are amazing. Thank you. Before I go, I got one more little thing. One more thing. We had a big anniversary recently, and it's so much fun, because I never know what the Lutheran's going to do, because usually we do the big gifts. You know, like I get a furnace, he gets a snowblower, you know. Secret bag from him. No furnace goes in a bag like that. And he says, look in there, find the gift. And I start digging in, and there's like really cheesy, cheap chocolates from like Walmart that maybe melted, you know, it was kind of weird. Hershey's Kisses. And then I pull out the biggest pair of white underwear I've ever seen in my life. All of you could be in it, you know, it was just you. He's having fun, you know, and thinking kind of guy, and that was big enough to look like sailcloth. And I said to him, you got me cruise tickets, didn't you? You got me tickets. There's the cruise tickets in here. And I'm digging in there. And he's laughing because there's no cruise tickets. I pull out the tiniest vibrator I've ever seen in my life. And he's laughing. And he says to me, we've never had anything like this in the bedroom before. And I fessed up. I said, hey, haven't you seen the tool chest on my side of the bed? Thank you, Black and Decker. You guys, thank you so much. I'm Karen Pickering. Before I go, I'm going to bring back our fabulous MC, but I want to promote something, if it's okay. If you're in the Twin Cities, once a month, Wendy Mabry, who's an awesome comic, and I produce a show called Day Drinking with website. I'd love to see you, and I also hope to come back to this place, because this place is a damn great riot. Thank you so much.
You're awesome!
Give it up for Karen one more time. Also, the rest of the comics tonight, all of them. One more time. Big! Make it loud! That doesn't count. Tonight is about the comedy. Make it happen. So before we close tonight, that was our final comic. I do want to say a couple things. One. Lisa, it's always you. Lisa, it's always you.
Thank you.
Love it.
That works.
Okay, that works. I'll accept that. Anyways, tonight, let's... First off, the comics. We did that. Secondly, the bartenders and servers that are walking around helping you guys. Give them credit. I'm a restaurant manager by trade. I started out as a server. I respect them 100%. This is my first time ever doing this type of shit, ever. I've never emceed an event. I've never hosted an event like this before.
Except for wedding, hello.
I didn't host it, you did. Still sounded like you, Lisa. Anyways, let's give credit to those who are here. Let's donate to Coco's heart. There's a bucket right there. She's got one in her hands right now. Throw some money in there. Give to Coco's heart. It's a great charity benefit. Just reminded me, the comedians have donated their time. They weren't paid for this. This back room was donated by the owner, despite the Badger game. It's a playoff game, and he still let us use it tonight. Give credit to that. And he's Wisconsin born and raised. So tonight, I want to thank all of you that stayed here throughout the show. Respect you all. I love you all.
Except, go have shots.
Go to the bar. Have shots on Mitch. And also, okay, I said I wouldn't do it. We're going to do it. We're going to sing happy birthday right now to the two birthday girls that are here. Courtney and Holly. Let's do it.